Hi, everybody. This is Christine Petty from SiriusXM Radio's On Broadway channel. Welcome to the Godspell 50th Anniversary Celebration and Trivia Challenge. Hey, here's a trivia question for you. Okay. What was the first musical I ever performed in? That's right. Godspell. See how easy that was? The rest of the questions aren't as easy. So let's head down to Greenwich Village and meet fellow Godspeller Paul Kreppel.
For me, this started when a friend of mine, Carol DeGier, who wrote the book, The Godspell Experience, which is filled with amazing trivia, facts, incredible things about the process of creating a show like Godspell. She said, let's do a trivia quiz. And the more I thought about it, because of my relationship with Godspell, I wanted to do some trivia, but I wanted to give some insights to the amazing, unique development of once-in-a-lifetime experience that Godspell became for a bunch of kids. 50 years ago, May 17th, 1971, Godspell opened up off-Broadway, right here. But that's not where Godspell's story begins.
John Michael is a deeply spiritual 20-year-old kid, went to an Easter Sunday church service, blah, 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 droning, blah, 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 ritual. He was deemed inappropriately attired by this community, and he was frisked by a parishioner who was an off-duty cop with the assent of the congregation and the minister. No shit. So he walked out of there heartbroken, asking several burning questions. This is the way he communicated it to us. Wasn't Jesus poor? Did he get the wrong dry cleaning? Wasn't he hanging out with the poor? Wasn't he constantly addressing the needs of the poor? And where's the love thy neighbor as thyself love?
When did you first meet John Michael?
Probably at the first rehearsal for the show at Carnegie Mellon.
I was a directing major at Carnegie Tech. And when we were freshmen, we had this little summer camp thing to get to know each other. And we got very close in those 2 weeks before a freshman year.
I think you know the whole story of me and Sonia walking down the hall of the Fine Arts Building and seeing our names on the casting board for The Godspell.
We were cast in a master's thesis, all 12 of us. We were bewildered by it.
And we knew John Michael as the sort of the Afro directing guy who walked around with overalls with ducks on them.
John Michael, brilliant guy, but he had trouble kind of articulating his vision. Some people dropped out along the way. They were so disheartened and confused.
Oh my God, what are we doing? What is this?
At one point he brought in some grease pencils and he told us to paint ourselves up. And we kind of looked at him and said, well, what does this have to do with anything? He said, well, you're going to paint yourselves up at the beginning of the show. And we said, you mean we're going to play like this? He said, yeah, you're clowns. And that was all it took. The door opened and there was this explosion of creativity. Somebody, Godspeller, once said to me that being a clown made us braver. And I think that was true. It was a euphoric experience, transcendent, euphoric to play.
So that was our first introduction to John Michael.
Do you know where Godspell was first done in New York City? It's a multiple choice. Was it at the Cherry Lane? Was it at Cafe La Mama? Or was it at St. John the Divine? Do you know? It was at Cafe La Mama.
I got a call from John Michael. I was opening a store on Walnut Street in Pittsburgh. And he said, would you come to New York to do Godspell at La Mama? And he guaranteed me that it would be for no money. And I jumped at the chance. So I left the store vacant and moved to New York and did the show.
Coming from CMU, it was like we'd made it, you know, we were in the New York theater world.
La Mama, where we improvised for 6 weeks to create this out of John Michael's mind and heart, this beautiful labor of love.
I think my main reaction to seeing Godspell at Cafe La Mama was to be surprised at how funny it was. I was so impressed that these parables had been around for 2,000 years, and John Michael was the first person to have the insight to realize that there could be humor in them.
Oh my goodness, what a surprise. We were picked up.
Stephen Schwartz was brought in to compose new music for the hymns and psalms that were used in the La Mama production. And the question is, for what new song in the show did Stephen Schwartz suggest that he write both the music and the lyrics? And why?
The origin of the song, All for the Best, was basic musical theater 101. Two characters, in this case Jesus and Judas, have a relationship that's central to the story, so they ought to sing the song together. And I always admired the song You're Just in Love by Irving Berlin, in which two characters with different points of view sing their own separate melodies, and then the melodies are sung simultaneously in counterpoint. And so I decided to try to do something like that.
I most especially have to mention Stephen Schwartz, who remarkably wrote a song for me to open the second act using the only three notes that I could sing. Thank you, Stephen.
Here's a follow-up question for all of you. What song from the original Cafe La Mama production did we decide not to replace, and who wrote that song?
By my side. And Stephen literally said, quote, Peg, I tried to write something in that spot and I couldn't come up with anything I like better, so I'm keeping it, unquote. And I'm so grateful to him, because what a generous thing for a composer not yet had his first big New York show to do for somebody else. Wow.
Here's a question. What music inspired the song Day by Day? Was it the Blue Danube Waltz? What the world needs now is love. I could have danced all night. And the answer is What the World Needs Now.
Day by day, day by day.
The original Godspell Band.
Gary.
Hey, how did you all get this job?
I was an aspiring songwriter, and I went to RCA with my songs, and in comes this young kid and says, who's my 3 o'clock? And I said, that would be me. And he said, follow me. And over his shoulder, I swear to God, he said, I hope you have some really good songs here because I've heard such garbage today. That was my introduction to Steve Schwartz. We made some demos together, and then I started working with Pippin. Got a call from him, and he said, forget about Pippin, I've got this show called Godspell I wrote, and I want you to play piano. And I said, Steve, I play for myself. I've never played a New York musical before. And he said, you'll be fine, you just play just like me. And so that was the only confidence I had going into this gig. And I think I met you all. Richie, you came via Joanne, maybe?
Yes, absolutely. We were in a band together.
Yeah.
He said to me, should I go into this show with Stephen Schwartz? And I said, who's Stephen Schwartz? And then she called me 2 weeks later and said, they need a bass player. Sing a high D. And I said, well, I can do that.
Rich, weren't you a guitar player at the time?
Yeah, I was rhythm guitar and lead singer in band, and I played bass in one band, but I did have a bass, I think. No, they bought me a bass. They got me a bass.
Joanne recommended some high school friends. They were too busy. I was only 19 at the time. Rick is, you know, making a living as a drummer. Call him. And Joanne was like, oh, yeah, I remember Rick. So she called me. Steve Schwartz came out to parents' living room. I was still living home. I was still a baby. And Steve played on our living room piano, and I set up the drums next to the piano. we ran a few tunes. He plays the last for you. And I'm like, oh my God, this is crazy. I looked at the piano music. I went, all right, forget the piano music. I saw a lot of time changes. So I just played it by ear. I channeled some of the English drummers on that one. And he just turns around about a third of the way through and said, nobody even thought of that. You're the only guy that thought of playing this that way. I love it. Are you available? Can you do this? So then he says to me, I need a guitar player who can play acoustic guitar. So the best acoustic guitar player I know lives right down the block. I called Jesse from my kitchen with Steve sitting at the kitchen table. He goes, yeah, let me check it. I'll be right over. Literally, he was there in 2 minutes.
I got over there and I remember Schwartz playing all the songs on Ricky's piano. And then I said something like, that's guitar music. And then I played some of it back and he goes, hey, I want you to be in the show. And the next thing I know, we were at apartment on 90th Street in Park Avenue. And the door opens up and Angela Lansbury standing there. And there's Stephen Schwartz at the piano with the investors. There were all these people around him who were listening to him play the piano. And I kept looking at Ricky. I go, this is real. This is real. And so that's how I got involved, because of Ricky.
Wow.
Brokenhearted that I wasn't invited. I didn't know at the time that the dean had told John Michael that he couldn't take seniors. Because that would have blown graduation. It was a very small class.
He called me. I was on the West Coast. He said, you've got to come and do this because nobody knows what they're doing, especially me.
So after I graduated, I went home and there I was sitting around trying to figure out what I was going to do. And John Michael called and invited me to come to New York and understudy and usher.
Andy Rohr and I were the original understudies at the Cherry Lane Theater, each covering 5 roles. The original cast got paid very little, and then Andy and I got paid way less than that. But if we ushered, we could make an extra $17.
Liz Lathrum was the first female understudy, and the two of us had great fun there at the Cherry Lane. Robin put me up, and I'm very grateful to her for that, and grateful to have had such a lovely experience.
What did Godspell, Follies, and Jimi Hendrix have in common? You don't know? I can tell you this because I know. The artwork for the posters for all 3 were done by David Byrd. And we were very lucky to get him. I remember Stephen and John Michael really wanted to get him because he was sort of the hot designer of the time.
True or false? The Cherry Lane cast called themselves the Rat Family because they idolized Sinatra's Rat Pack and thought they were cool.
The Cherry Lane cast were called the Rat Family, not really because of Frank Sinatra. It was an abundance of rats.
Everybody had a rat experience.
We're improvising on the Cherry Lane stage. John Michael Tabalek is sitting in the house. Suddenly, Lamar runs all the way downstage and he goes, rat! Screaming, and John Michael goes, yes, yes, Lamar, that's the freedom and the passion I've been looking for from you. And Lamar said, no, darling, there's a rat the size of a Buick and he's sitting right next to you.
They were rats. There were so many of them and they were huge.
I just remember hearing stories, hysterical stories of them watching a rat crawl across stage, and sometimes they were in the audience.
You'd sort of see our garbage kind of move. You know, the garbage that's a prop garbage.
One time I thought I saw Jeffrey's hat moving across the floor by itself, and we were pretty sure the rat was inside there.
I don't know if they were equity, but they were part of the show.
And I think on our night off, they might have done a tribute to Sinatra and the Rat Pack.
That's when we started calling each other La Rat and Gord Rat. And
so we officially named ourselves the Rat Family. I am Peggy Gord Rat forever.
There weren't a lot of rats. The day we moved into the promenade, it was like going into the Four Seasons or something, which didn't exist then. But it was like going out of the Cherry Lane into the promenade was such a ray of light.
Air conditioning.
1972, the song Day by Day, sung by the company with Robin Lamont in the lead, was a top 20 song, probably in the top five in New York for sure. We heard it everywhere we went. It was following us. Godspell had become a national phenomenon and a worldwide phenomenon. Okay. Now, speaking of a national phenomenon, how many North American companies did the producers and creative team send out? And can you name them? Well, the answer is amazingly nine, including New York, Boston, Chicago, Washington, D.C., San Francisco, Los Angeles, two touring companies, and Toronto. Very talented kids got their start in all these companies of Godspell. Toronto is particularly legendary in Godspell lore. So here's a question related to that. Which of the following young actors was not in the original Toronto cast of Godspell? Ready? Okay. Which of the following young actors was not in the original Toronto Godspell? Eugene Levy? Gilda Radner? Victor Garber, Andrea Martin, Martin Short, Celine Dion.
Okay, Andrea Martin here. Which of the following talented group was not in the original Toronto production of Godspell? Eugene, Victor Martin, Gilda, Andrea, Celine Dion.
Well, that, of course, is a trick question. And the answer is Victor Garber. Victor did Alias and other things, but Celine Dion was my favorite, actually, of that cast. She did Turn Back, Oh Man, like, first of all, very lean-faced, which was her trademark then and now. And I don't know, she always said Turn Back, Old Man, though. She never quite got the lyrics right.
I have very vivid recollections of the Toronto production of Godspell, dynamic work from, you know, Marty Short and Victor Garber, Andrea Martin, Gilda Radner, Celine Dion, of course. I don't honestly recall me being in that production. So I would say Eugene Levy. And I think Levy is the proper pronunciation of his last name, my last name.
Right. Celine Dion was not in the original Toronto production because she just didn't have the vocal chops. It was between me and her, and she was eliminated in the first round.
Here's a follow-up question. In that legendary Toronto company, who was the equally legendary Toronto musical director? Can you guess?
Who is a Toronto pianist, musical director? Paul Shaffer!
Yeah, who was that Toronto musical director?
Come on, Paul Shaffer!
A really good piano player, I remember that. I just, name escapes me.
The pianist, musical director of our production of Godspell in Toronto was the incomparable Mr. Paul Shaffer. Yeah! Ah! And even then, he looked like a maitre d' on a spaceship.
You know, I happen to do a great impression of Martin Short, if you're interested.
Did any of you kids know each other before Godspell? Eugene and Marty knew each other.
He's the only one I knew. Everyone else I met that day. We were so excited when we got this these coveted roles, and we ran back and kept trading off using the phone, where, you know, we only had so many dimes, to phone everyone we knew.
And I knew Eugene because we had done a wonderful film called Foxy Lady together, Ivan Reitman's first movie.
And she was an actor in that movie, and I was coffee boy on the movie. So I did get to work with her the following year on a movie, acting with Andrea in a movie that needs no introduction, Cannibal Girls. And that was 1 year before we started Godspell. Did I know that it was an incredible group?
You know, in those days, I didn't really know what a career meant. I just knew that we were had a job, and it was at the beautiful Royal Alex Theater, and we were like-minded people, and it was in the 70s, and so all hell broke loose, and there were no barriers or anything. We just had fun.
But we just thought, you know what? We're having the time of our life doing this show.
We were trying to do the best show we could, and but it was the happiest year of my life in show business, so I guess that made it incredible.
And so how did the movie come about?
Evidently, David Green, who directed it, visited all the companies and saw a show. But he, as far as I know, we didn't know when he was coming to Boston. We had found out he was there. And I quickly, in my mind, I went, yeah, good. Okay, good. Yeah, okay. It was a good show. And got a phone call. And that was it. It was the easiest audition I ever had. They did do something that we later found out. We had a day of shooting in Central Park, the 10 of us, and they just we sat around, we talked, we sat on the grass when you could sit on the grass, and then it turned out it was just like a screen test. They wanted to see everybody on film. Of course, we didn't know it.
Wow. So here is a wonderful trivia question, because this is a trivia event. On the movie soundtrack album.
Yes, I have it in my head now.
One of the stars of Godspell, and the entire cast is on the album. One of the stars of Godspell is not in that photo.
Gee.
That's the question.
And the answer is me.
Really?
Yeah.
You had another job for the same producers, and you had done all your principal work. You both had the long, curly, dark hair and the mustaches. They asked me to come and be you in a couple of numbers. And so I ended up on the cover of the soundtrack. So I thank you for that.
Why
did you let me do that?
I know you needed the money, and
thank
I thought,
you, very much.
You know, as long as he keeps his head down.
The only thing that looked alike about us in those days was this, and yeah. David Green kept saying, keep your head down, keep your head down. And I said,
keep your head down.
I said, I'm 4 inches taller than he is, and I'm a little thinner, and I'm
four,
a little...
4 inches taller?
I don't know.
How tall are you, 5?
I'm shrinking.
Oh, well, the incredible shrinking Herbies.
Happy 50th, Jer.
Yeah, you too. You too.
Now, after all these years, actually going to Broadway? It's fabulous.
But not only did you go to Broadway.
All right, we toured Broadway in Godspell. We started off at the Broadhurst, then we went to the Plymouth, and then we went to the Ambassador. It was very cool to be in all those theaters because I had been in them to see other, you know, great shows, and now I'm in them, and they were fabulous, and they were, the rats were actually smaller in those theaters than they and at the Cherry Lane.
Lamar.
Lamar was
probably the sweetest man I've ever met in my life. He was always there for you. He was always concerned about your health. And then he sang, and the gods just cried, you know?
And Jeffrey, my leftist.
John Michael did Summer Stock in Cleveland a year before he did even wrote Godspell. And I was lucky enough to go and do a couple shows with them. And Jeffrey was there, and Tom Rolfing was there, and, you know, a lot of the guys, but Gilmer was there. We had a wonderful time.
And the incomparable David Haskell, who was biblical. And our dear Herbie.
Bless you, Herbie. Thank you. Thank you. He came up with this guy, and we just went after it, you know, the best.
We will always be Herbie clowns.
Yes.
If they say 85% of directing is casting, then John Michael is brilliant, because the original cast of Godspell created an amazing template of characters to bring this tale forward.
Is the legacy of Godspell and the Godspell family still part of your lives?
I just think, what has the show meant to you? What has it? What is its enduring experience for you, plainly and simply? And for me, it's the enduring experience is one of gratitude.
Without John Michael and without Steve, we would have never met.
It's a rare, rare and wonderful gift that I never, ever, ever take for granted.
In the early days when we were doing gigs and signing autographs at different music stores and places like that, I was generally with Jeffrey, and he used to sign his pictures with, "May the spell of God always be in your hearts."
The people that I did the show with live in my heart always.
In 1972, was cast as Judas, the Chicago production of Godspell. Another young actor at the time, Richard Gilliland, initially was the understudy to Jesus, but soon took over the role. And so for the better part of a year, we were Jesus and Judas in the Chicago company of Godspell. From that point on, from 1972 to this year, 2021, which is just shy of 50 years, we were the best of friends. He asked me to be the best man at his wedding, and I, of course, asked him to be the godfather of my child, who was born 2 days before he got married. Both my wife and I and my family loved Richard with all our hearts. And I say loved because just a little over a month ago, his wife, Jean, called us and said Richard had suffered a heart attack, had been rushed to a hospital, was on life support. And on St. Joseph's Day, my patron saint day, he passed. So 50 years of memories is what I have left. And I remember on Easter Sunday, which was just a short time after he passed, his wife wrote me a text saying, "It's Easter. He was Jesus. Where is he?" To kind of add to that kind of purposeful, macabre sense of humor that we both tried to stir up to get through this, I said, "How do you think I feel? I'm Judas." So it's been tough. But don't just shed a tear because they're gone. But have a smile because they lived.
of the Lord.
I feel like I've changed careers every 8 years. That's basically what it is.
Weren't you a private detective?
Yep.
Then you got your law degree.
Yep.
And you were like an assistant district attorney.
Yep.
And now you're an author.
Yep. This was Interim, The Trap. And this was Right for America. I'm married, have two great kids.
Then and now. How long have you been together?
49 years this past February.
Yep. Going on 50. You better start to learn your lessons well.
Okay, so the Godspell motto, the short version is, Lamar found it in the New Yorker, and he came in and he said, oh my God, he said, this is perfect clown logic. So he was right.
Gathered around every night before we went on stage and put our arms around each other and recited the Godspell motto.
Keep the corners of your mouth turned.
Speak in low, persuasive tones.
Listen. Be teachable.
Laugh at good stories and learn to tell them.
For as long as your green brother
or sister,
you can grow.
Right here at the Ambassador Theater is where the original production of Godspell's final curtain fell, if we had ever used one. September 4th, 1977. From Carnegie Tech to off-off-Broadway to off-Broadway and Broadway. What an amazing journey.
Hi, I'm Paul Shaffer. Happy 50th birthday, Godspell, you know. A hit is a hit is a hit is a hit.
Hello, fellow Godspellers. Sonia Manzano here, wishing us all a joyous 50th anniversary.
Happy 50th anniversary to all my fellow clowns.
Godspell may have given me weak knees, but it gave me the strongest, most enduring, and treasured friendships I have to this day. Ever grateful for that. Happy 50th.
Happy anniversary, everyone. Love from London.
Hey, Godspell family, I love you. I think about you all the time. Happy anniversary, okay, guys?
Godspell was a transformative experience for me. Lucky me.
It was great being a part of the Godspell family. Happy 50th, Godspell.
Oh, bless the Lord, my soul. Happy 50th anniversary, my fellow Godspellers. I remember when, because I was there.
Okay, it's 50 years, and I still got to ask, when wilt thou save the people?
Godspell, you are 50 now. Jesus Christ, just tell me how. Out to conquerors, take a bow. Happy anniversary.
Godspell, it was 50 years ago. I can't believe I'm not old enough. I must have been in a remake, I think. Anyway, happy birthday. Weren't they good times?
Wishing happy 50th to Godspell and the Godspell family.
Happy 50th, everybody. Godspell, because we've been taking it day by day. Love you all. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Blessed are the peacemakers.
Godspell, 50 years.
Love thee more dearly. Anyway, it's Barbara Deutsch. Happy anniversary. The best time of my life and the best job of my life.
I have lifetime friends that I treasure from the San Francisco company. So I send you all the best from my home in Baja, Mexico.
Wishing everybody connected with the show a very happy 50th anniversary. I love you all.
Hey, Godspell, happy anniversary. 50th. Oh, boy. Baba da baba. Have fun.
Hey, fellow clowns, happy 50th. Unbelievable. Happy 50th.
I am so thrilled to be joining you in celebrating Godspell's golden anniversary. Peace, love, and happiness.
Happy 50th birthday, Godspell, from Carla DeVito, the 6th National Company of Chicago, at the Studebaker Theater from 72 to 73, cast at 19 by Nina Faso, sang All Good Gifts. Loved everything about it, started my life. Love you all. Happy, happy. Woo!
Hi, Godspell world. I'd do my by-my-side reach, but I'd be out of frame. So I just want to say happy 50th, you amazing creature, you.
Yo, Jesus! Hey, dude! Whoa, what happened to your hair, man? It's like gone.
So thank the Lord, oh thank the Lord. Happy anniversary, everybody! Woohoo!
Sending my congratulations and my love to Godspell and all the Godspellers still kicking around. Happy 50th.
Day by day by day by day by day by day by day, 18,250 days, 50 years.
Happy 50th from the Horn Sisters!
Hey Godspell, happy anniversary, and thank you for the best, most wonderful friends I've ever had. And I got to work with Gilda Radner. God bless her. Happy anniversary, Godspell.
Hi, everybody. This is Jeep Fortuna, originally with the Washington Weasels. I've just had my second hip replaced, so I'm being recertified to jump off a chain link fence 8 days a week.
Godspell gods and goddesses, you are the most talented, hilarious, and flat-out craziest clowns I have ever had the privilege to work with. I love you all. Happy 50th.
When a man in authority asks you to make a short video,
make it twice as long!
Happy anniversary, Godspell. I'm Jim Parks from the Chicago cast.
Thank you, Godspell. Happy 50th. Let's end that on a happy note. Day by day.
Day by day by day by day. Happy 50th, Godspell. Oh God, how am I going to get there?
Did you say 50 years? Feels more like 51, doesn't it? Larry Russell here. I played drums and bass with the show. Played with a lot of talented people. I wish I could do it again.
Happy anniversary, Godspell. Happy 50th anniversary, Godspell. And thanks for all the good gifts.
I love you all. Hopefully we'll be able to do this in person and be able to touch each other.
My amazing Godspell family. 50th anniversary. Wow.
It is no exaggeration to say that Godspell literally changed my life. Oh, and by the way, this is the original Godspell t-shirt, which I am proud to say I can still fit in after 50 years.
Happy 50th, Godspell. I certainly cherished my 3 years in pigtails.
Happy 50th, Godspell. Thank you for my life and my home and these incredible friends I've had these 50 years.
Bless the Lord, my soul.
Happy 50th, Godspellers forever young.
You all had your shots, right?
Oh, it's better.
Michael Lloyd here, wishing you a very happy 50th anniversary.
And I'll see you at the 60th.
Happy anniversary, Godspell. The best time ever.
Godspell, I'll tell you, I'm thinking of that song constantly these days, day by day. It's a good way of looking at the world, 2020. Anyway, God bless you all, and here and there. Take care, Godspell.
Happy anniversary, you brilliant people.
Be 1, 2, 3, the pickup on 4, happy. 1, 2, 3. Happy 50th anniversary, everybody from the band.
There we go.
Whee!
To see thee more clearly, love thee more dearly, follow thee more nearly, day by day.
Godspell people, to each and every one of you who is such an inspiration to me over the years, God bless you all.
Happy anniversary, Godspell.
Happy 50th anniversary, Godspell.
Okay, so my two biggest memories are climbing up that fucking ladder every night to the keyboards, but then getting to play for Dolores Hall. Happy anniversary, everybody.
Happy anniversary, everybody.
We beseech thee, hear us. Hi, everybody. Happy anniversary and masses of love from this old West End, we beseech you. Weren't we lucky?
Happy 50th anniversary, Godspell. You look good for your age.
Happy 50th anniversary, Godspellers.
Happy anniversary to all the Godspellians out there.
Remember during rehearsals, very beginning, find your clown. That's all we heard. Find your clown. Well, we found our clowns, didn't we? And we'll never forget it. Carry Godspell with me forever and ever. Love you guys.
Happy 50th anniversary to all of you adorable Godspellers. I can't believe it was that long ago because it makes me much older than I thought I was, but I still remember it, and I am so proud to be a part of this group of people. And I wish you all so much love and congratulations.
Of my clowns.
Happy anniversary to Godspell and to all of us who have been a part of it over the years.
Look, the gang's all here. Look a little different, don't I? Happy 50th. Here's to 50 more. Love you all.
Happy 50th anniversary, everyone. Sending my love and God bless.
Happy 50th, everyone. I love you all and miss you.
I'm so happy that I can actually say happy 50th. I love you all.
Happy 50th. See you at the 100th. I love you.
Love to all Godspellers. Thanks. Day by day.